This video is sponsored by Sagenda. Sagenda takes care of your booking schedule so you never lose track of your appointments. Learn more at Sagenda.com. Google Forms is a great way to create easy contact forms, quizzes, samples, surveys, and so many other things. So in today's video, I want to share with you five of my favorite tips to get the most out of Google Forms. Hello everyone, Scott Friesen here at Simpletivity, helping you to get more done and enjoy less stress. And let's dive right in with tip number one, and that has to do with our responses. Now, once you've set up a form and you've shared it with others, you can always come up here and click on the response. Responses tab, and it gives you a great summary, whether it's a chart format and telling you how individual users or the group as a whole has responded. But what if you can't wait, or what if you want to reply to that individual as soon as they send the form? This is especially helpful if you're setting up a contact form. Well, over here under the responses tab, we want to select these three dots. We've got this option to get email notifications for new responses. Now, this is essentially just a checkbox. If I click on this, it has been unchecked. But if I come back and click on it, you can see that it has been checked. Meaning now for every time that this form is submitted, someone submits this form, I'm going to receive an email notification. Now just make sure that you know that this notification is going to be sent to this email address. Wherever you have created this form, that is where that notification will be sent. You don't yet have the opportunity to customize or change the email address, but by selecting this, you will get an immediate response whenever someone completes your form. Now, speaking of completing their form, what about if you want to share this form in a different format? One of the most common ways to share our form is to come up here and select send, and we can either send an email directly, but probably more frequently we are sharing this link. And don't forget to hit the shorten URL option here so you can share this via social media or just looks a little bit cleaner. So you can copy and paste this link and send it to those who you would like to fill out the form. But what if it's something that you'd like to include on a web page, such as your website? This is very useful, especially if you're creating a contact form. Well, the third option here is to actually embed your form. You can embed the HTML of your form. Now, if you need to, you can try some trial and error with the width and height here to see what best suits the page that you're going to paste this. But all you need to do is select copy, which is going to copy this piece of code and then bring it into your website editor or wherever you would like to include it. So let me just delete this for a second. I'm just using a quick and easy HTML code editor to show my example here. So I'm going to paste the HTML here on the left-hand side, and we're going to get a preview on the right-hand side. So if I paste this, here you can see my form, the way I've designed it, is going to be displayed just the way I like. Everything from the formatting, the colors, and the behavior of that form. So instead of creating a button on your website, instead of just creating a link, you can actually embed the form itself. So they don't have to click anywhere else or go to a new page. They can fill out your form. All you have to do, again, is come up to send, choose that last option, and copy this piece of code and place it on your website. Now, tip number three is especially for teachers or for those involved in training, or maybe you just want to quiz the people that you've been speaking with or who have been taking some of your training or reading some of your content. You can turn any form into an auto grading quiz. And this is all you need to do to make use of this. Here I've created a quick and easy sample quiz, just a few couple of questions based on this video. So in order to do so, what I need to do is come up here to the settings here, and I'm going to choose the third option, which is quizzes. And I can say, make this a quiz. So if I select this option, I get a number of different options down below. Number one, do I want to release the grade, release the scoring immediately after each submission, or do I want to have to wait until I see it and I can tell them when I've reviewed it and released their score? down below, we also got a few options in terms of what the respondent can see. Can they see the missed questions? Can they see the correct answers? And can they see the point values? You can determine what you want to allow those who are participating, those who fill out the form or fill out the quiz. Make sure you hit save before leaving this page. And you hit save on this page, we come back to this form. Now remember, I haven't actually set this one up as a quiz. So now what I need to do is click on these questions here, and down in the left-hand side, you can see I want to click on the answer key. If I click on the answer key, I've got two options here. One, I can say how many points is this question worth? I'll say that this question is worth 5 points. And next, I'm going to say that yes is the correct answer. If they want to get the 5 points, they have to click yes. Come down here and say done. And now I see the point value here and this little check mark telling me what is the correct answer. Let's go down to this second question, which is different. It's not multiple choice. I'm going to click on this again. I'm going to say it's the answer key. I'm going to give this one, give this 10 points because it's not multiple choice. And here I can add one or more answers as the correct answer. So in this particular case, I'm the one who created that video. So I can say it's Simpletivity. If you want to add other variations, maybe you think they're going to have trouble spelling the name. Maybe it's the first and last name or just the first name. You can choose to add multiple correct answers and say mark all other answers incorrect. I'm going to check that box and I'm going to say done. And so here I can see the answer key when I'm previewing, or if I'm wanting to add more questions to this form, I can do that as well. Now I can send this as a quiz, and after it is submitted, the person who has filled this out will receive that feedback immediately. They'll see how many points they received and they'll see what the correct answers were. Now, tip number 4 is something that many of you have been asking me over the last several weeks and months, and that is, Scott, can I use logic branching within Google Forms? Can I give someone some special questions depending on how they've answered an earlier question or something else in my survey? And the answer is absolutely yes. So let me show you how to do so. Here I've got a sample survey, and the key to logic branching or to presenting other questions dependent on what their earlier answer was has to do with sections. So a reminder, here on the right-hand side, the very last option is to add a section. You can add as many sections as you want. This is often used to sort of break up your quiz or break up your form into more manageable or more digestible chunks. So maybe they're only answering, 3 questions per page, and then they go to the next section. But if you want to use some logic branching, you need to create a section for those different places where you may send the people who are answering or based on their answers. So here I have section 1 of 2. This is the main quiz. It's just going to be a simple yes or no question. But what I want to do is I want to send them down here to section number 2, which I've already created. Now, I only want to send them here if they answer no. If they answer yes to this, that's great. The quiz or the form is completely done, it's over, and they can go on with their day. But if they say no, I would love to hear a little bit more from them here. So all we need to do in this case is we're going to go up to this question here, we're going to click these 3 dots, and we're going to say go to section based on answer. So I'm going to select that option, and again, I just want to show you, it's checkmark now. So now it's waiting for that behavior. So now you see I've got a drop-down menu beside each of my answers here. So if it's yes, what I want to do is I want them to just finish the form. I want this form to be done with, submit the form. If they say no, I want them to go to section number 2. That's sort of that key question. Now remember, I could send them to a bunch of different sections. I could send them to section number 3 for this, or section number 4 for this one. I'm going to keep it simple for this example. The last one I'm going to say, again, just submit the form. If they select yes or other, I'm just going to say finish the form. But if they say no, I want them to come down to section number 2. Now, after each section, you also have another choice to make here. In order for this to work, in this particular example, I want to make sure that it's submit form after section number 1, meaning that after they've finished this, if they answer any of these questions, I want to finish off the form. However, this logic is still going to apply, that if they answer no, they're going to come down here to section number 2. So let's see it in action. Let's see if it works. So let's come up here and hit that preview button. And let's start off with the easy one. Did you enjoy using our services? Yeah, it was great. I'm going to hit next. And hey, thanks so much. You can click submit to finish. Everything is over. Let's come back and hit that preview button again. This time I'm going to select no, and let's see what happens. I hit next. Oh, okay. Well, what could improve your experience? Would you like to set up an appointment to discuss this further? So you can create some fairly complicated logic and branching with your forms depending on those questions. Now, the last tip I want to give you today has to do with adding something that we sometimes forget and can often spruce up our forms, and that is the ability to add video. You can add YouTube video directly to any of your forms. And the way that I like to use this is that I will present a video and then say, you know, answer the following questions after you've watched this video. So let's take a look at this in an example. On the right-hand side, the fourth one, or the second one down from the end of our list is add video. If I select this, what I can do is I can do a video search. So I'm going to say tutorial here. Let's say Google Forms tutorial. I want to do a quick search here, and I'm going to find this video. I'm going to say select, and what it's going to do is it's going to bring it right here into my form. Let's say I want that to be the first thing that they see. So I'm going to drag that up here. And again, this is not a question. It's not something that's gradable. You can't add a multiple choice with this specific video, but what you can do is say, watch this video and then answer the questions. Okay, so they know, I've given them some direction. This is what I want them to do, is to watch this video, and then they can go down below and answer those questions. If we go back here to the preview button, you can see it's embedded seamlessly here within my form. They can just hit play and start watching this video, and then I can have as many questions down below as I like. Now, if you need clients to book time with you, be sure to check out Sagenda. Sagenda is the scheduling system that integrates directly with your website, so you can fill up your calendar without the additional work. Learn more and get started for free at Sagenda.com.